Welcome to little document where you can see Rally Finland from my eyes, from eyes of a passionate spectator. We are going to the ceremonial start at the moment
with Thierry.
And we are really late, but I didn't want to use a lot of time for this now. It may be that I cannot get a good spot, but I hope I can see something. And it's the first ceremonial start on modern Rally Finland, so let's go and check how it is. It has been really rainy, but now there is no rain, which is good. And there has been already music and every, you know, other kind of systems going on, but the drivers will be starting, or the proper ceremonial start is starting after a half hour, so that is the thing that I'm interested in. After that, let's go to home and plan a little bit for tomorrow. But anyway, here it begins, best weekend of the year.
Ahead of it all?
Of course, it's always amazing rally. It's one of the coolest ones of the calendar. Always a huge support from the fans. It's a legendary one, so why not? It's a really good thing.
Now you have...
here for you. They saw you do something really special last year at this event. How are you feeling ahead of this one? Are we ready to aim for the top step of the podium?
Last year, this year is all from scratch again, so let's see. I mean, it's a great event. It's a pure performance for the machine and for men, so
which you have won before. How are you feeling? Are you feeling confident ahead of this one?
Well, yes, in front of this amazing
support. Jari Matti Latvala yhdessä Juha Hännisen kanssa. Kolta Jari Raima.
Yes, it's a very special and big thanks to Aki Otojärvi for the courtesy to get this opportunity to drive with the car. It's an amazing feeling. I really feel honored to be in this position. We already did a bit of a...
That was the ceremonial start. As I know, not the best place. I came so late, but I see something and that's not so interesting anyway, so it was okay. So it's approximately little bit less than 23 hours, and the stage is starting here in Harju, special stage number one. I go to check that spot because I was thinking that on Friday evening, if the place where I'm on the final forest stage is boring, I may have time to come here to see the second round of Harju. It's looking pretty nice. There will be the chicane and then some kind of slowdown junction before going to the small gravel road. So in case I have time on Friday, I will go here. But on Thursday tomorrow, for sure, I will start on my traditional place.
Okay, it's midnight. So basically, officially the first rally day already. I'm still a little bit eating. I did a little core training when I came home, and of course loading everything, the power bank, both batteries of the GoPro, old phone, which will be my rally radio source, and then the new phone, which will be, well, everything else that I need from the phone. The plan is really same than last year, really simple, of course. For tomorrow, shakedown 9 a.m. I will use the parking area 1, and I thought it's approximately 30 minutes when I order travel from my home to the parking. It will be shorter, but I always put a little bit extra in rally situations. I leave from home 5:30, I will be at the parking 6 a.m. and 6:15 at the spectating spot. The spectating spot I will use is the same than last year. The first dropping left. I thought a little bit that I would go to the first right, but then I was thinking that the dropping left is more difficult, and there you can more easily see who is confident and who is not on the first runs of shakedown. And that is important information for me, something that I want to see. And yeah, parking area 1 here, roadside parking, nothing special, and the walk to the place, it won't be long either. Let's say I can park the car there. Here we are on the stage entering row. The stage start is somewhere here. And then the walk will be like 1.2 kilometers. So easy day. I will check a little bit also the warm up. The plan is to leave the spectating spot 10:30. I like the warm up. I watched it last year. It's nice to see when the drivers are talking a little bit to each other and, you know, just doing the warm up things. It's nice atmosphere there. Then I will be at home at 12 approximately, spending 2 hours on the home. I will eat properly and maybe get some rest. I will go to the service, either with bicycle, walk, maybe tier, who knows. I will be there 1 hour, around 3 o'clock, and then I will go to the Harju special stage number 1, which start at 7 p.m. I will leave the service park 3:30, and then I will be 4 p.m. on the Harju area, just when it opens, to get the best possible spot from my favorite place. You can check the Harju as well from the official Kuide still. It looks like this, and my favorite spot is this year's the spectating area D, and my entrance to the area will be then here, so nothing special.
One thing I forgot to say when I did the plans, that of course I will do the plans for tomorrow and especially for the other days, but for this video I have no plans, and the plan is to do no plans. This will be totally raw footage of my rally, and that is like the whole idea of the video, so it will be what it will be. But now, good night. Okay, the traditional thing happened and I cannot sleep, so let's do a rally veikkaus. This is a Finnish Discord server around Rich and Burns rally, but there is also real life rally chatting. And the rules of this one is that we need to guess the top 6 of overall, then the top 3 of the WRC2, and then who will drive most of the fastest time. And if you have a correct name on the list, you get 1 point, and if you have the correct name on the correct position, you get 2 points, if I remember it, the rules right, and then who will drive most of the fastest times, that's also 1 point.
And I need to take risks because on the overall situation of the season, I'm on the bad position. And the risk number one is that I will put Tanak on the front. Because for sure he have the speed, but the reliability of the Ford is so bad. So that's the why it's a risk. Evans on the position too, because he has been good on the changing and slippy conditions. And now the conditions will be like that. He won here 2021 when it was a slippy rally. Lappi position 3 because he has been really good in Finland, but not so good on the changing and slippy conditions. Neville position 4, I guess Suninen will be faster, but they will do the team order, so there is no point to put Suninen top of Neville on this list. Latvala position 6 because he will beat both Lupe and Katsuta. Not maybe by speed when we think about Katsuta, but Katsuta will do some mistake. There is no Rovanperä on the list, and that is the risk number 2. He haven't crashed yet on this season, and almost on every season, even the top drivers will crash once, so it will happen now. That is my risk.
But now let's check. 2 hours and 35 minutes before alarm. Not too much. Yeah, no chance. Yes, I was laying on the bed. Yes, I kept my eyes closed, but no, I didn't sleep at all, so.
Okay, let's put the trip to the zero so we can follow the total kilometers of this weekend. And the weather looks okay. It's pretty cold, 17 degrees, but it's damp and a little wind. It feels colder than 17. You know, so many times on these rally mornings, the feeling that did I pack everything I need? Rally pass, radio, food. But at least I have the rally pass, that is the most important.
I'm one of the first. Maybe the people who have been sleeping on their cars are here, but I think they are still sleeping. There's already like car after car after car. 3 hours 20 minutes before the stage is starting. What is this? Okay, I check where is this Alvet parking on the other side of the road. It seems it's somewhere there. I can already see the car, so I will use that side of the road.
It's crazy.
I mean, it feels, in my opinion, that every year this goes crazier and crazier. After 10 years, I think we need to be here on the next evening. And remember, it's only the shakedown.
Moment. Road condition looks like accepted, damp, but definitely not wet. Pretty, I would say, traditional rally morning conditions, and these are actually really nice. Soon we will see if there is already spectators on the stage, or if they were all sleeping in their cars. There was already first one. Those are morsels, I think. Putin Latte. Sausage point.
this would be the first quarter, which was my option. But I will go to the second. There is already many people. Terve.
Pääsinkö mä täältä rikkinäisellä itselle? Sen verran kuuluisa kaveri täällä, niin pakko tulla toivottaa tervetuloa.
Terve, terve.
Ja hei äiti, älä lähetä lisää rahaa.
Ai. Hyvää huomenta.
Täällä taas.
Kyllä. Pääsit siihen sisäpuolelle. Sitten kyllä harmittaa, jos siellä saisi katsoa.
Ihmettelin, jos pääsi.
Attends, descente là.
Ei. Nikolai. Kovaa vetoa taas kerran.
Kiitos. Missä olet kattonut?
Sama kuin viimeksi, puottava vasuri alus. Let's try to go through the where the start junction to the start is. The traffic is going better and better all the time, so I guess it will be possible. It was nice again. I think it was good choice to be on the first corner because, sorry, on the second corner because again there were slides from both Evans and Katsuta. So the same drivers than did a really wide line last year did perform again on this year. It's weird, but I don't know. Yeah, really different kind of approach to the corner, interesting to see and then listen the times. But I would say that almost the best that the shakedown has to give is then the when I walk back and you can see what the drivers are doing, listen what they are talking, chat with them. I was talking a lot with Kriasin. And yeah, then see quickly Kalle and Suninen and those, everyone there, it's nice and it's good feeling to see a lot of drivers and that kind of stuff. And it's not more than 11:15. Already see a lot of friends and you know people who I know from the sim rallying, so nice starting again. But I have to say that now that is like seen the corner where I was two times in a row, I won't do the third time anymore. So let's hope there's a new shakedown because that is the best spot of this. Maybe they could reverse the driving direction, I don't know. But something new I want for next year. Traffic seems to be okay. There is massive amount of cars. Was it like 2 hours before the stage was starting on 1.5? When this roadside parking was full. So massive amount of people, and because the field parkings are problematic, those are so wet, there will be more and more people now on the side of the roads. And this is something I need to really think about for the next days also. It may be that I cannot be changing the stages so much than I would like to, because you just can't arrive to the stages so late. There's so many cars now on the side of the roads. I hope that the weather will be shit, like Grönholm said, raining a lot, because that would make maybe a little bit less people going to the rally and thus a little bit less people on the side of the roads, but let's check. Yeah, really, we are here on the Keljonkangas, part of the Jyväskylä, where this roadside parking stop, so lot of people. And hey, look at the weather. No rain and even sunshine at the end of the shakedown, so really good.
it should be a lot more, or it could be a lot more wet considering how are the systems at the moment here around central Finland. So, but there you can see, you know, that kind of high clouds. Normally it means rain. Let's check. I would like to see some rain on the Harju states. It would make the downhill nicely slippery.
Okay, let's check shakedown results while I'm eating. I cannot film what I'm eating because I'm transferring the files from GoPro to the computer at the moment, but on the first run it was Tanak who was fastest, Lappi really close, then bigger gap to the Rovanperä, Evans, Suninen, Evil, Katsuta Lupee, and Latvala pretty slow on the first run, but that was of course not a surprise.
Okay, it's soon 4 p.m. I skipped the service park because I needed to sleep. I thought it's a smart choice considering the rest of the weekend, but let's check after the Harju. Maybe I can go then there or tomorrow, who knows. Not so important for me because I saw it already quickly yesterday and it's always every year the same, but let's check. But now we are going to the Harju with the bike. Weather looks okay, it's sunny now, pretty hot actually. There are clouds here and there, not extremely dark, and the forecast is saying that little rain can happen after 3 hours, but that's all. And I think if I would like to go to the service park and see the cars, the top cars, I cannot be watching every car here, because if I'm right, those will go to the Parc Ferme then for the night. But good thing is that many slower cars are going before the top cars now on this evening. It's a special road order, so I think I could see enough when I leave after the top cars and then I could go to the service. But I don't know, there are already lot of people waiting that the whole area is opening, so similar thoughts that I had on the shakedown, that there are maybe more people now than last year, at least everyone is really early. It's already like, I don't know, 50 people, quite a lot. Moro.
Reppu auki vaan.
Ja sieltä löytyy saretakki.
Jes.
Ei.
Se on kaikki nopeasti.
Okei, okay, mä avasin päätaskua ja se oli vaan silleen jes. Oli tässä vielä kaksi muutakin. Plus nää kaikki pikkutas.
Kannatusta koskevaan uutisjuttuun. Jutussa kerrottiin, että kokoomus ja perussuomalaiset menettivät
12 asti.
Tallinna.
Haasteita paitsi turvallisuuteen,
niin
Thank you.
tänä viikonloppu kistää on kolmanneksi nopein. Parat pitää kilpailun kärkeä.
Menkää siellä, mä menen tää sun.
Crazy amount of people. I need to lean back so the people who are pushing me front wouldn't destroy the little people that are in front of me. I don't like that, but this is nice. I think I am not going to the Hyundai, which is there, because I was there already yesterday, so it's pretty much this what we can see here now.
Sitten itse tämä kysymys. Saatte selvittää ensimmäisen vaiheen. Se, tämä on varsinainen kysymys, että missä autossa on kaikista eniten rock'n'rollia?
Eikö sun tarvii nyt vaan tuota, voit vastata seuraavaan kerran?
Joo.
Joo. Terveisiä sinne ja tota, niin pidän lapset nukkumassa huomenna.
Mä voin. Joo,
minä voin.
Yeah.
eating a little bit, a lot now. Starting to make the final plans for tomorrow. I will tell you them when those are ready. Weather look like this. Not really good. Basically, but on the other hand, it makes things spicy. But yeah. Pretty late. I will listen to Bensa Suonissa and make all the plans. Do some food for tomorrow. And then when everything's ready, I show you the plan and go to sleep.
So I'll be starting from Laukaa. I will go to the Lappis place. It will be parking area B8. It looks like this. Sorry, like this. So it's a roadside parking. And the Lappis place is somewhere here. So let's take it closer from the proper map. This is the roadside parking road. And from this junction, we go to the stage. So let's check. Let's hope I can park somewhere like here. 500 meters before the junction. And then let's check roughly what will be the walking. 2 kilometers, so it will be like 20 minutes approximately. So the stage is starting 8:05. And Google Map is showing that I will be driving there 40 minutes. I calculated 10 minutes extra. Because it's morning, normally not so much of traffic. 10 minutes should be enough. So it's 50 minutes total. I will be leaving from home 5 a.m. I will be at the park 5:50 and on the place 6:10. Then I will be changing to Halttula through, and there is now two options. There is a good area on here at the end where I would like to go, but it should be pretty popular, so my backup plan is actually here, where I will then go from parking area B5. And the plan is that, where is my Google Maps? Here. There is the B8 of the Laukaa stage. I will be leaving from here, and then I will be driving to the Lievesture, small village. And this is now already the road going to the B5, which is not actually here. It's here, approximately. But anyway, the plan is that I go here to the road E63 and I try to go here. These are the final corners of the Halttula stage. I try to go here, and if it looks good, I can leave the car here. So I would have a 2 to 3 kilometer walk from the roadside, and that's okay. But let's say if the traffic is going to look really bad already somewhere here, or I heard from Rally Radio that there is a lot of people and that kind of things, then I just change to my backup plan and I will go here on the parking 5. But whatever I will do, the schedule is pretty much the same. I will leave from Laukaa on the place, from the place 8:35. I will be at the car 8:55. And then I will be at the parking area of the Halttula 9:45, because the driving is approximately 50 minutes. I calculated 20 minutes of extra, because there should be a lot of traffic. And then I calculated that I can be walking like 30 minutes maximum, so I will be on the place, on the spectating spot, 10:15. From Halttula 2, I will be changing again back to the Laukaa. I will use the same parking area, but go a little bit different place from so-called adrenaline place. These schedules and systems are approximately the same. So I will be leaving from Laukaa 12:20. From Halttula spot 12:20. I will be on the car on the parking 12:50. Then I will be on the parking area of the Laukaa 2 on the B8 13:40, and on the spectating spot 2 p.m. That's only 30 minutes before the first car, but it doesn't matter so much. It shouldn't be like a really popular spot, so I guess it's okay. And again, I will be watching only the top cars, and I will be leaving from this place like 15:15, so I can see like all the Rally 1 cars, and then let's say maybe 5 of the top Rally 2 cars. I will be at the car 15:35, then I will be on the next parking area of Halttula 16:35, and at the spectating spot 16:50. Feel only a little rally day, but feels like a proper rally already. And it's a weird feeling, because it has been 1 year since the previous rally, but it feels that it was just like few days ago. It feels like, you know, you have come to home when the rally is going again, so.
Okay. It felt surprisingly easy to wake up, but now it's starting to feel not so easy. But
at the same hill where I was driving with the bicycle to the Harju, special stage Harju is there. It's a little bit later than was the plan, but I felt that I have no reason to hurry. Weather, it seems a lot better than I thought. It's not raining at the moment. Of course, it's pretty dark the sky, but not extremely dark. Now in the mornings, we don't have the rally radio yet. It's starting something like 1 or 1.5 hours before the first stage. So there is no the latest information coming from the parking spots. And of course I cannot, you know, scroll my phone, check the social media all the time because I'm driving. So I just trust that the P8 is still open. I will be driving there and then let's see. And again, it's 17 degrees of Celsius warm or cold. It doesn't sound so cold, but there's little wind and the moisture, so it feels pretty cold. I think it was exactly the same degrees yesterday morning at the shakedown, so pretty similar weather. But yesterday it went, you know, better and better during the day, but now it should go another direction. Okay, there was some accident, for sure I'm not showing what was happening there. Let's hope everything goes as well as they can on that situation. That's one reason why I think that it would be good that we would have the rally radio already this time of the morning, so you know people could get the information that there's that kind of situation now, in case that will cause more of traffic. One interesting thing about this day was that where are all the people going? So many are talking about Mühimpää, where I'm not going now at the moment. How will it affect to the traffic of these Laukaa states and Halttula, where I am going? I don't know. At least at the moment there's no traffic at all. So I can see maybe 5 cars behind of me, especially when there was the little stop. And that's all. I guess I am early enough. Now the only question is like, how many people went there last night already? Is it like 1 kilometer? How much cars there is already, like it was on the shakedown? I don't know. But what comes to the traffic, I was definitely early enough. There is our final junction, if I'm right, for the P8. I remember when I was a child and there was not so much information and everything. Those were a lot more important, those signs that they are putting side of the roads. And it was always interesting to check if we are going to the right parking, where are the correct parkings and everything, but now. Now you can check everything all the time from the phone and the map, so it's not so this is now first time we see gravel this morning. For sure, this is quite a big road, but in places it's also like this on the stage. And it's definitely a damp, so this is good for Kalle Rovanperä, who is starting first on the road.
It's first not cars.
So is it really so that I was so early enough here that I got like the best possible park, which is basically here now on the left. It's there behind of that Mercedes. Okay, this was really good. And then I just hope that it won't be too many people here, so I could get somehow okay place for the second loop as well. But then I will be driving footer to the next junction. But this was really good now. I think it's okay. It's coming 6 o'clock, 16 kilometers driven, and I will pack the backpack what I need and then let's go. So I want these, then I want my yogurt muesli berries combo, and then I will take one Tehosport and we are ready to go.
Let's go with the traditional chocolate, the orange chocolate that I did yesterday. It's actually a little bit more fresh than this, really good. But this is the original that I like. So it's 6 o'clock and now it's important to check how much it takes this walk. And look at that blue sky. Should be a rainy day, but blue sky. Moment. This is the what kind of forest it is. Pretty open, and there is actually some stripe. It will be leading to those fields, which are official spectator area, if I'm right. So it's quick to run back, at least so far. And then the next 500 meters at least will be fields. So it's quick to run back from those. So it's the final 500 meter now. That is a little bit question mark, which kind of forest it is. We will see soon. There are water splashes on the road, but there is not that kind of layer of water on top of the road, so okay condition, I think. Now it's thick, the forest. I mean, that kind of is really bad now when it's wet. Okay, so this section for sure I will be using the road when I go back. Or can I use the... I could basically go there from the fields, but it would make a 300-400 meter loop, which is not good. And then when I just would run that piece of road, it would take 50 seconds. But we are at the spot. I've been walking really slow, even stopping a few times. And it took 20 minutes, so that's okay.
Tästä tosiaan sinne myöskin perässä ja tästä seuraavaksi kun lähdetään ajamaan.
Yeah.
way to the end corners of Hautulais, asked my friend if there is still room. Let's check it, he answers. And yeah, the place was a little bit more boring than I thought, only cause that it that kind of driving than I thought I would see, that kind of sharp direction change. Otherwise, everyone else were really smooth. And one zero car, they put a stripe there, so I couldn't see the place like I would want it. But that kind of things you cannot just know before you are in the place. There were, when I came, there were, you know, a few spectators, and we make a deal that we are a little bit back. But then more and more people came, and then they were so close to the road, then the zero car just said that now we need to make an extra stripe. But otherwise okay, feeling is good and fresh, and the traffic so far is okay, it seems I'm pretty much front of the people who are changing the stage, and I didn't get a response from the end of the Hautula, how is the situation there, how many people, how many cars on the parks, still need to wait that, and we have like 15 minutes before the decision that I need to make, if I'm going to go to the end of the Hautula or the end of the B5, somewhere on the middle of the Hautula station. Stream, endless stream of cars, but we are still moving a bit faster than 80 kilometers per hour, so it's okay. But after like 10 kilometers there is junction, and that may be a problematic place in case there's a lot of cars in front of me, because we are going to the road which is going from Jyväskylä, and there will be car after car after car going to the Hautula end, and I would need to make the turn to the left, so it can be a tricky. It is like the critical point of now, the first critical point of this. And then the next critical point is when I see where is the end of the car parking or the possible traffic issues, where I can still make a 180 degree turn to the back and go to the B5. So still a little bit of waiting, and then we see. Let's try to be clever. I don't know if we can say clever, because everyone else are taking this road as well, but Google Maps didn't show this one, but let's try. This will be now really close to the end of the Hautula where this stage is leading. So if it is full of people, then I just need to go back. But if that is the case, the turn that I need to make when we are going to the big road is to the right. So it should be okay. Okay, I got now information from the stage end that on the best spots there is two or three row of people. But then not so good places, it's better. And I think it's enough, I will try to go there and find some spot. It's, if you do these kind of changes, it's, you know, the thing of these plans that you are not getting the front row. Maybe on the morning only, maybe on the second pass, first stage, but not after these hurry changes. So nothing new. And now it's the first stop. There should be two junctions, both to the right. And then we are going to see how it's 2 minutes. But at the moment it seems that there's no traffic at all, at least on this direction. And this direction is good when I go back to the Laukaa. So there would have been okay roadside park. But it would have required an, again, 180 degree turn. So now we are really calculating where is the end of the parking stop, where I could do a roadside parking. Because at the moment there is a parking for a bit. Whoa, there would have been really nice. Damn!
Siihen jäi kaksi Fordia samalle pätkälle.
Ja katsotaan maalissa.
Kyllä, tää oli itseasiassa Petteri Sulbergin paikka, missä lupea ajoin pitää.
There is no. It may be that I could use this road to go back to the road where I just came, but it shouldn't be a big problem to turn the car then if it's needed, because again I will be leaving really soon, and that is a grass place what I'm going to go watching now, so most of the people there are going to watch all the cars. Okay, at the end it went pretty well, and now straight through those fields, and I'm on the spots where I actually maybe can ask those people where did or where they were coming, if I can use this road to go back. There was the information that we can go to the, where I want to this road, so I'm going to do a game move now and turn the car. I just... Now let's go.
You know what, I would have the, you know, proper wet shoes on the car. And now the walk is really short, no need to run. But I didn't understand the take, I like forget. But for sure I'm not coming back anymore, so... It's stupid that you have something that you would have needed, but then you just don't use them. Look at this. I have no idea that there are systems like this big. You can like get everything you need. Actually, there is a pathway. I thought that the long and wet grass would clean my shoes because those are full of mud. Parking forbidden and parking. I don't know now where this road is going, but I put the map on and let's check. Schedule is okay. I was watching 20 minutes more than I there was on the plan because the walk between the car and the place was so short. I thought it will be 30 minutes, but it was 10 or not even that. Impossible to believe that 99% of the people, of the spectators, understand it. But then there is that 1% on the front row standing on top of the ladders. It was on the official rally radio opening show. The boss of the whole race told that it's forbidden to use those things, to bring those things on the stages, or at least if you do so, go to the back road.
Old Mini Coopers, one of my favorite cars.
No time to go to check. I would like to have that kind of, you know, car with engine of motorbike and then rear wheel drive or four wheel drive system. That's my dream. The darkest cloud so far of this rally. But these are not maybe. It actually may be that those are going straight to the end of the Laukaa stage. And yeah, hey, the place of the previous one, it was good. Like really high quality place in my opinion. It was a really possible crash corner, Suninen, really wide there, almost totally off the road. And then the next corner, proper long sideways drift corner. And you could almost see both corners and there came places. Train. Otherwise it's not an issue, but if the rain is happening and I'm running to the car, it's bad because if I use the rain jacket, it will be really hot.
00 toistan 044 421 67 00
end of the is there like more cars or is this just this caravan? Yeah, it's just this caravan. I thought that the end of the traffic would be here.
200 kossulmon korostettu pöydälle, mutta kyllä näyttää tänäkin auton ympärillä olevan hiljaa.
Westernmark and what is happening here?
Siinä ei myöskään vielä sitä toistakaan autoa.
Interesting way to pick up the trashies like that. I hope there are marshals. Who knows if there is place for the cars or not? And I could ask. There has been now a few people turning around. Or should I park here? 128 kilometers done.
Long the walk. Those cannot say sure. If there is room on the roadside, or if I need to go to the fields. And right at the moment, I can hear from the rally radio that no one is going away from the fields without the tractor help. So, no point to go there. The walk is better no matter how long this will now take. First time now when the bicycle would have been good. The start of the tarmac is like half a kilometer away and then from that it's another half kilometer to the stage and I've already walked half a kilometer and then I have 850 meter when the stage is starting to the spot where I want to be. And really clear already to say that it would have been good to pay the parking and take the risk that there wouldn't be a room because there's like 300 meters at least already the room on this one. Because the run back to the car, I haven't been, will be most likely the heaviest in many years I have done in Rally Finland. I was thinking a little bit should I took a nothing with me, only another battery to the GoPro, left all the food and everything to the car. But I'm hungry and tired and it can be raining, so I need food and equipment. It's not slowing me like maybe 5 minutes in total running time that I have the heavy backpack, but it's making the running worse. I cannot, you know, maintain the proper running position. There's, you know, some muscles are going to get tired really easy and then you need to just fight against the tiredness of small little muscles instead of just run. There's actually a possibility to go there almost all way with pathways. That leads to the pathway and then there's like 100 meter through forest when there is a small road
then leads exactly to the spot where I want to go.
That is the road that I'm coming back, maybe. Or should I? Yeah, I try that road now. This. Let's check. Big some kind of a junction. This looks familiar. I think I was here some years ago. There's some, you know, part of pathway. Let's check what will could be good. Yeah, well, going straight is good. Ah, so deep water splashes, but okay, this is not a bad way, but this must be the way that I did. Was it? It was 2021, I think, when I did first time this first person spectators. And then I went like through that open area. But it's so high buses now that I don't want to do it again. If there would be a easier way to go past it here on the steeper forest, because this is easy to walk. There is so much, you know, fallen little trees everywhere. And the buses are higher than me. So it's slow. Here I can maintain the normal walking speed. Oh, that's what I thought. It's going to be pretty steep forest. I have only t-shirt, so you can imagine that all these wet sticks and leaves are feeling really fresh, let's say like that. Oof, really thick forest. Oh, the road is there where the open area ends. Oh, let's go through that. This forest is too thick. No matter what is the open area condition. Okay, this is actually pretty okay. The biggest issue were there, that piece, but this looks a lot more open. I just would like to find some good rocks or high places where to parkour, because all those holes here are full of water. These are the berries that I have on my breakfast. Really good. minutes now from the car with slow walking, so by running it's easy 15. Be now an option to buy some sauces, but I need to be so athlete that I cannot eat it now. It would ruin my running performance. Experience pays off. These are exactly the rocks that I went last time. Then to the thick forest. I left 10 minutes earlier than I had on the plan, because there was information there's a lot of traffic on the between Myhinpään Halttula, so I took a little bit more time for myself. Then it's somewhere there, the, where it starts the pathway. What? They are doing these roads with a car. Only for, or not for the normal cars, let's say like that. There's no traffic at the moment, so no need to run like a crazy at all.
It was good. Of course not my first time on that place, but it's still spectacular. And I think last time I was here, it was with the previous generation cars. So now it was less downforce and those were jumping a little bit. I tried to think that what could be that kind of, you know, spot now when there is deep ruts full of water. It should have been rained a lot there. That could be somehow interesting, but I cannot figure out anything special. Then the final corners, but I was already there, so I'm not going there again. So let's try something new and watch some slow place finally of these proper stages. For sure the place at the Harju was slow, but it's a little bit different story. Lot of people. Some year I will try to do with the motorbike. I have done 2 times. Now when I have more experience about all the roads and spectator spots, it could be quite nice. Works nicely this traffic control.
Considering the flicker that is off
up both of these cars. I think these are going straight as well, so
yep,
few minutes, and considering there's no any people now on this road, I guess this should go right. And there's good amount of time. I will be sending some messages. There's two options, the junction or then another tight corner, that if I can find someone who has video on the another corner, if the spectators were all of it to be on the little better places than where were the official spectators, but I could walk there, but otherwise I will stay on the junction. Hairpin kind of junction, right? Sorry. First roadside park car. It was like mixed roadside and field parking, for sure I'm not paying about the field. Especially now when I'm not in a hurry. So let's check. We are approximately, I don't know, maybe 1 kilometer away from the junction. Really difficult to know if there would be room, how much. I guess there is, because there is cars coming all the time, but how many cars are front of me going to that direction, I don't know. It seems here is the end of the roadside parking, so pretty okay. We are like, how much is that? 300 meters from the, now I lost the wall system. 300 meters from the junction, so it's okay. That's it. Now I try to find the information if it's good. The one tight corner well would be like 2.5 kilometers from here, or if I just stay on the junction and see the hairpin. Both would be okay places to watch all the cars. I have no hurry in the Jyväskylä because the traffic will be massive. I prefer to be here in the forest and then I go home even midnight. But I don't want to be there in the traffic. I take food and all the systems, so no matter if it's raining or not, I will have a good time anyway. Stay here. I asked and there has been like one slide on the tight corner that I was thinking. Nothing else on the first loop. But here you go.
Putkosella olisi niin kuin megaliitto.
Oh,
koska tässä on kuitenkin palkinnoista kyse, niin mä aion nyt, se ei pelaa, joka pelkää. Ja joskus pitää ottaa riskejä.
Pretty boring place. I thought it would be more spectacular that people or driver would left the brake more late because, you know, uphill braking, good compression and grip, but no. It was basically pretty boring. Of course, you could spot some differences with the drivers. For example, Suninen, it looked like he did not countersteer at all the time, front wheels pointing inside of the corner. He used the handbrake, but still that kind of really clean approach to the junction. And Oliver did like 4 or 5 mini Scandinavian flicks, and Heikkilä braked too late. And I watched some of the Rally 3 cars as well, but the gaps between the cars were some random, sometimes like 10 minutes, and then I thought that I will quit. I need to go to the shop because the AirPods or whatever are these systems got broken. Only the right one is working. So in case the right one will shut down tomorrow as well, I can't hear the rally radio, and that's bad. It's showing on the Google Maps already that there is traffic.
It's standing the traffic.
And there is this game information for the rally radio that is even difficult for the drivers to reach the Jyväskylä at the moment, so let's do. I go there from the Laukaa stage where I came to the Halttula stage, and from Laukaa to Jyväskylä. I will have now 20 minutes to the Laukaa, and from Laukaa it's 40 minutes to Jyväskylä, so in total in 60 minutes. And I'm pretty sure that on the traffic it could be more than 60 minutes.
Now we can go actually check the Mini. Third time when I'm here today. It's nice and it's beautiful. I would like to have that kind of car. Not maybe with those stuff on the roof, but otherwise.
And then proper technique inside. There was an accident. I'm not going to tell more about that. But the thing that I can tell, I think, is that I was first car who then came on the place. So I need to call help. And of course I tried to do whatever I can to help when waiting the proper help. And then of course I need to stay there quite long. And I think that's all I can say. But when I came here on Laukaa stage in the morning, there was a crash or accident. Maybe that's a better word when we talk about the road section and normal traffic. And now when I go off to home, another accident, so need to be careful. But yeah, now I'm a little bit late, really tired. I have this kind of system luckily still. And again, imagine the luck with the weather. When I was there on the accident place, I don't know how long, 45 minutes maybe, no rain at all. But when I was driving there, it was raining, and when I started driving, it is raining. So really good luck. I haven't really felt the rain today. Only there on the Halttula first, but otherwise all the rains has happened when I'm in the car.
Ralliradion ilta- ja yöohjelma bensaa suorissa. Viihdyttää ja kiihdyttää.
Täällä on 4 kysymystä on sivullaan. Niin mikä sivu ja mones kysymys?
No se on 10 sivu ja 2.
Siitä on tää itse pääkysymys. Missä, no niin. Missä autossa on kaikista eniten rockerollia?
Rieselin-rotke.
Missä Rieselin-rotke? Ei oo siellä paikalla.
Sanotaan näin, että selkään ja paikalla istutaan ja...
Tehdään se.
Let's go to the Prisma.
These are like 30 euros and these are 10. 10 is enough. basically it will be nice to go to the service again, because they are fixing the car of Kalle, they are fixing maybe the car of Lappi, maybe the car of Lupe as well. I'm not sure what's happening with him and his car, but not maybe anymore.
Hangon Tulliniemi 18, Lounas 8. Pitäis käydä mitään ja lähti vaan perse alta. Oliko kelillä osuutta? Kyllä siinä varmaan vähän oli osuutta, kun lähti pito varmaan mudasta tai jostain.
Joo. Almost clean socks.
Finally. First portion of lasagna and I will be eating many more, as much as I just can for tomorrow and for recovery of today.
Pretty much eat. I eat now, then need to do food for tomorrow and then plan tomorrow. I still can't decide what should I do. Take a risk, try to do 6 stages, do a boring normal 4 stages, 3 stages with really high quality place with long walk at the morning. I don't really know. But
okay, it went a little bit late. The same guy who last year gave me some ideas on the Friday, Saturday night, gave me some ideas again. And I was really thinking those. But the end result is that I keep my plan. But anyway, that new thinking took like 1 hour more. It was 5:15 when I need to leave my home, so 4:45 should be enough time to wake up. Really likely I will be really slow in the morning. I'm so tired, but it should be okay. I'm not expecting like millions of people on the place where I'm going. Let's check what the clock is saying. Let's put a little bit more. 4:44. So it's, how much is it? 2 hours and 2 minutes. Well, that's more than 2 hours, which is always good. The waking up will be really crazy. But I know that if I just can survive that, and when I go outside of the door, take some Red Bull, start driving, listening rock music, it will be okay. The critical moment is the when my every 3 alarm is waking and making the concert for me after 2 hours.
Yep.
Good night.
Oho, feels
difficult and, well, that's all, feels difficult.
Merisää again. Best way to start the morning for sure. And again, it's 17 degrees. 3 mornings, always 17 degrees, and I guess the moisture and everything has been pretty much the same. It may be that the wind is now maybe a little bit more warm, or then just less wind, so it doesn't feel so cold, but otherwise, pretty similar morning than the previous has been, and now let's head to the legendary Jämsä stages. Rally radio started. Do you think that you are not going on the first stage, only to the second stage of the morning, is that the rally radio is pretty much with you already when you have been wake up? Kippis. Yesterday tea still worked really good. Normally I don't use caffeine at all on my normal life, but it makes this working, but the effect goes smaller and smaller during the weekend.
Where rally is rock.
Good morning, rally fans. This is Rally Radio Morning Show with Anu and Ari. And like Colin McRae said, straight roads are for fast.
there's like van and there's some trailer system. Going 50 kilometers per hour. So the evil roundabout. Here you have, you never ever want to be here on the traffic time.
Okay, those are turning now, so
the road is open. It'll rain, nothing special, but not so much light and not so much brightness than there was on the Jyväskylä fishing. More heavy rain. And to the full rain, and it seems it goes maybe even a little bit harder there forward. Legendary Ouninpohja is there on the left. Hopefully some year. Imagine how long the stage analysis would be. 5 to 6 hours. Yep. It's raining hard.
Hyvää matkaa sieltä Kaliasalla Ranskaa tai jonnekin muualle, mutta se ei ollut oikea vastaus. Otetaan.
There is almost even standing water on the little ruts on the road, so it has been heavy rain here. Should be sleepy. Should be good. I remember already somehow this road from, I think it was 2015 or 2016 when I was here. The last time when I was here I didn't have any GPS or other that kind of navigation system. I just had the, I think I had on the paper or on the phone just listed like the name of the roads. And soon the roads are so small that they don't have a name. So then I have put it like the 5th junction to the right, the 3rd junction to the left, and that kind of thing, and that was my, how I find the way. And the small road continues and continues and continues. These kind of water passes there could be also on the stage when there is the small road section. Guess what? The small road, it continues and continues and continues. Land. Cars. Yeah, there is people. I am not so alone than I thought.
The 69 Asia Drive.
There is already the stage, so we are really close to that. Let's actually check. Yeah, this is okay. I can reverse to that. There is even some caravan parking there, so it may be that there is actually quite a lot of people already. Yeah, this one I can, it's actually pretty wide edge of the road, so it's okay. Then just rain boots and rain jacket. This is slippy. That kind of wet clay layer top of the hard-paced road. Really slippy. There I've been once, now it seems forbidden. If I could see those four corners from there on the inside, I could try that now. Otherwise I may be going to that direction. The long is pretty, the view is pretty long from there, but here will be closer to the possible action.
Sama. I left 50 minutes earlier than I should, almost. It's just the level of trying and attack is so little that I got boring. I had no internet, so I have no idea now about the afternoon plans, what would be possible and what not. So I drive away from here, small road to the big road, and then I stop somewhere there and check all the chats and information, and then to do the final plan for afternoon. One kilometer of driving and I got the internet. The 120 WhatsApp message is just about rally. And I'm pretty sure it's not even loaded, all of them. And on Discord, the number will be like 1,000. The place was okay. Or really good corners actually, but when I was here before I was watching them from the front. Now I do there closer to the actual corners and it wasn't so good. Of course you can better see the possible mistakes and that kind of things, the reason of the possible crash and slide. But the angle of watching wasn't so good. And I thought a little bit there was that little wall where I had been. There was no stripe, no people or nothing when I came to the place. So I thought that okay, maybe it's forbidden. But then a little bit before the first cars there, people went there and it was okay. So that was the traffic information and everything should be good. Let's start checking. Okay, I'm updated. I will listen the Vekkula states from Rally Radio and then let's talk about the new plan.
Elvin Evans sets the fastest time on special stage 14, Vekkula 1:10.09.4. And Nikolai Grios in car number 25, setting a time for 10:57.5, and obviously it's not
probably. Here now. The Pitkäjärvi, and there's some road preparation going on as well, it seems. Nice and flowing tarmac next. It's actually, even if we are really far away from Jyväskylä, which I don't like, basically what comes to the rally roads, but nice to drive new roads and see new places. Of course there's like basically nothing new compared to all the other places where you are in Rally Finland, but still it is new places. Maybe this is not so popular place the end of this stage, I don't know. But yes, I'm really early, it's 3.5 hours now before the stage is starting.
Church of the Eräjärvi.
Shop. Se on vetomies TR. E7 TR. On the field. No, I'm not going to the field. Definitely not. Has it be any roadside parking forbidden signs on this side of the road, but that's really weird. I'm not going to stop instantly here. I go a little bit further away. And look at the weather. Sun is shining and everything is green and at least the road is dry. Feels like a normal rally Finland where I have used it. I used it to say many years that it never rains in Rally Finland and that was the case. Until now these two Rally Finlands that I have filmed. This left side of the road, it doesn't look so good. So the running will happen there on the right side of the road. And then there is some bad way. There is spectators walking already to the big road. There are some people already on the apex of the jump. Someone on there as well, wouldn't be a bad choice maybe, but maybe I took the apex, I want some adrenaline now. This would be the best, maybe, only for the jump. At top of the crest you can see the corner as well, so I took that now.
Because the road I am taking is only 3 minutes slower and then I will be avoiding all the parkings that are at the start of the Västilä. But that helped me maybe a little bit. There's a rally Subaru behind of me. Impress. like woke up. Rally one cars, changing the states. That is the what I like, what I enjoy. Definitely. You know, on the previous year I have been doing sometimes slower schedule, but now it feels that it's not my thing at all. I almost died because I was so bored. What a sound. Really nice road to drive. It's not so often in Finland that you have this so little tarmac road in this good condition. Even if the tarmac is old, there are no holes or ruts or nothing. And it's really nice and flowing. Soon it changed to gravel and then it's not so good because there are so many holes. But so little bit of traffic now, going only 50 km per hour, but it's not too long anymore the gravel road, so let's hope the speed will be higher when we enter the tarmac.
And that was a fantastic push by Evans because he took 7.8 seconds out of his nearest rival Thierry Neuville.
Then do the big road.
Another 23 seconds back, and he has him 3.4 seconds behind Mikkelsen.
Early. The stages are there, the rest of the stages. And the sky is full of clouds and pretty dark even. So it's pretty clear the difference, because here it's still sunshining. There is the junction to the parking area 1 of Västilä and famous parking, parking area of the famous places of Päijälä. So that's clear easily. And now I'm not a meteorologist, as wasn't Grönholm either, but it looks like a thunder almost. Yeah, I didn't thought this one at all, that I could have done this. It could be like Västilä-Rapsula and Västilä-Vekkula.
In question, so Katsuta loses 1.1 seconds to Sunninen.
Because it was so fast to game here, it seems.
Through Pajala. His comment, of course, that Pajala pretty bad condition already, cutting up big stones coming through, causing him some, well, discomfort anyway. 10:12:0 is his time, and we have. Yes, Ole Solberg, he sounds almost relaxed now.
I don't know, came out of nowhere now, pretty tired feeling, and there is one stage, it will take really long before I will be back on the car even. And then it's the same way to home than it was last year, when I need to take 3 naps to survive back to home. It may be the same situation, but now I'm smarter. I'm not taking too short nap. I take like a 2-hour nap if it's needed. So I think that would be a lot more helpful to get a little bit even deep sleep. P7 of Vekkula stage is full and I'm not sure now where it is. It may be that it's even the roadside parking of this road. Feels good to be here, close to the Koskenpää and Sahalonen, and then it's not so far away anymore to the Moksi. I like the Jämsä area of course, but this is somehow the home stages for me. I remember Peteiri, for example, the Ounipohja, and maybe Päijälä as well, but these are the home stages.
Ehkä tultu niinku kylki eellä siihen uraa vasten ja sit se on niinku sitä kautta lähtenyt kaatumaan hitaasta vauhdista.
Koko ajan moottoripyörää ja autoa vastaan ja se on erittäin hyvä asia, pysyy liikenne järkevissä mittasuhteissa.
Last year I went there to the right, if I remember right. Now I got there to the left.
And I will be walking the most worst road of the states and maybe of the whole rally.
So it's interesting to see. If I spot some really bad place, really bad ruts or stone, I can just stay there then and watch the cars. Not a bad option either. Would make the walk shorter.
Moro!
Kakkosen maalissa.
Hienoa, sun täytyy passi.
Kyllä.
Tuohon tarkastuksia sitten vihreältä mieheltä parkkilippu.
Paljon se maksaa?
Vitoset.
Se on.
This is now again the guessing game. If there is still room or not. I think I will pick the next one if there still is. Please. No. I turn around and go back. That is, I mean, already the same.
Siihen papin äänen päälle. Tahdot sinä. Se ja se ottaa.
Beautiful pocket parking and now ready to go again.
Hän alkoi juuri sävel.
Joo, tästä synnytysosasto hommasta on tullut se aikaisemmin.
482 kilometers done.
Onko kymmenisen vuotta sitten myöskin?
Eikö? Joku mittas se niin.
Jo. Pynskille pisti viestiä.
Jep.
Vaikeushan on loppu toimintaa.
Ei.
Sit kun tää kysymys on esitetty, saat sitten vastaus. Molemmat on ollut niinku aidon järkyttyneet.
That was good. Something good to this day. When I walk through that water splash corner, I was thinking that when will be the next time in Rally Finland this kind of condition that I need to use it now. So I skipped the original plan and went to this because there was the downhill, and from the downhill all the time new water came in. So the ruts were not empty even if the cars were throwing the water away because new water were coming in all the time. And on top of the, you know, water and deep ruts and mud and everything, there was the sunlight straight out the eyes of drivers like this. Like, I can see absolutely nothing. They need to almost, you know, break in the middle of the straight. So really interesting place to watch. And there was a crash on the first loop on National class. Now there was no one even close, but still it was entertaining and nice. Nice place to be, and I think it will be many years since or when we will see that kind of place and condition in Rally Finland again. Now it's time to go to home, no need to go to the shop or anything. I will go through Petäjävesi because it's quite a bad choice to go from Jämsä. There is so much traffic. So let's drive east to the Petäjävesi and watch the beautiful late night sunshine. And listen the bensaasuonissa, hey, of course. And this is quite beautiful road to drive as well. And hey, it was first and second time this rally when I watch all cars. And once I get, you know, a full load of mud, it was he was turning to the right side at the exit of the corner, so the front wheels were pointing straight towards me, and I don't know how much it is, 30, 40 liters of muddy wet, but I don't care. It was actually make the feeling just better. I'm thinking a little bit, should I go to the Moxie States now still to check where are the stripes. It would not make my way to home like extremely lot longer. It's basically on the good direction, but of course a little bit more corners. And there is now the park where I was last year. So it was P7, I remember it right.
Mulle on varattu tänne tämmönen äänipankki. Siis tänne tietokoneelle. Missä on kaikkea näitä näitä teko. Taisi vaikka tämmönen. Joo, mitä 12.50. Mutta siis miettikää nyt varsinkin te soittajat. Täällä on siis oikeesti.
Then let's go here, Sahloisten rantatie.
Maksamaan korkeampia talletuskorkoja. Ei jos ole painetta pankeille.
Really nice the landscape. Reminds me a little bit of the old clips that you have seen from the Thousand Lakes Rally. They were driven so many times in the really early morning, for example, when there was fog many times. You know, this could be the landscape of an early morning stage.
These kind of
beautiful place this time.
Vielä muutoksia koitetaan katsota siitä kampittaa, mutta pakko myöntää kyllä, että katsotaan ajanut myös erittäin hyvää kilpailua.
Amsamarin, hän yritti 555 kolmannella lajia. Se käänsi kilpailu.
Voisiko sulla
there, high on the fields are spectator areas. There is a cutting block. No stripes, but no go either.
Jaakku, moi.
Moikka.
Joko se on aika? Nyt on...
No tota, kyllä varmaan on High Ace of Spacesissa.
Yes. Jaakku, I love you.
This can't be true. They are hay bales.
Varmasti eniten rock'n'rollia, vaikka tuo äsken...
I need to take a photo of this.
Se täytyy olla... He ace of... Sinä ei lemmi Kilmister laulaa. Ja, ja. He ace of spades. He ace of spades.
That's nice. A lot more open than when I was here filming the stage analysis. But this is not an option if you want to change to the Himos anymore, in my opinion. Okay, then. Let's go to stage more reverse. To the home. Let's check if there is more surprises. That was really bad. I thought I could go to the end of the stage, but I don't want to see that, you know, going through the narrow hay bales. Then this is the interesting one. Not this situation, but this corner. There is some stripes there. What those are like meaning? It's just a walking road, isn't it? There are the stripe. I will go and watch what is the view from there. Okay, so high here. But I don't know what would be like the feeling to be so high and far away from the car then. I don't think that it would be really good. I don't know that either. Some places you can see the corner good, but you are so high and far away from the road that it would not give that kind of feeling at all. And then on the end of the area it was basically okay, but then you will see only the really late of the exit of the possible crash corner. To do this now, the wall. Let's do the small road loop as well. Why not? Rally is only once in a year. Now if the Lehmänpaska corner is somehow forbidden or ruined, then I give up and go twice the Himos. And at least there is no goal sign so far. Yep, it's all of it for the spectators, I think. That is an option for sure. But then I would need to find something. Where to go if I'm the first run here? Where to go next? That would be close to my car. And the car spot would be on that kind of road, that from there it would be fast to go to the Himos. Now that I could see this right, this left, this right, and this left from there. And then from backwards, this jump, which is here. A stage. There's actually no-go signs on that one. Could be an option as well for the second loop. Hey, the end of this road could be an option for the second loop. Because then the junction where I could left the car is like 400 meters to that direction. There is no area yet. That's surprise. Interesting to see, hey, now the junction area. How many they have already built up all the systems.
Meillä ei ole kysymystä tässä, mutta haluaisitko lähteä terveeksi?
No, tää on yllättävää, että se oikein...
Surprisingly little in case there will be those
normal systems, all the screens. Maybe not this year, because it's the first days of Sunday morning, so maybe there is not so many people going to be here.
Onhan siinä joku
logiikka ja onnea sinne jokaisen keksi. Sunset will be there, even a little bit pink on the clouds. But we go to the Mäkelän kylän tie. This is a nice piece of road. And you know what? The merisää is just beginning, so imagine this combination. You can listen to merisää while driving Mäkelän tie or Mäkelän kylän tie. Not bad. Suddenly the temperature dropped to 15. And instant fog. Could it be that tomorrow morning there will be really big fog? I heard that Michel Mouton visited this shop and someone crashed to the wall of that one few weeks ago. Long news break on the bensasuonissa Rally Radio Show, so I could do some kind of sum up. For sure, final lesson for me this day that I need to see many stages. That's for me. Sitting at one place and watching every car, it's not for me. On the final stage, of course, but what I did in the morning, it was a very last time. And then I just cannot understand why I didn't get the idea that I could do the Vekkula, sorry, Västilä Vekkula, Västilä Rapsula system, but it's not the end of the world. The first place for sure it was good. I just chose the wrong angle, but I wanted to see it from that angle as well. It's not a big issue that there were no any crashes, because everyone knows the place and there's small road loop just before it. It would work better without the loop. Then the second place, it was like a plan B, because the plan A, I got the information that it's forbidden. I cannot understand why, but that's sad. That could have been nice. I watched one onboard already from Västilä, and that could have been a nice place to be a spectator, but it was forbidden. So then I just need to figure out something where I can move out quickly. I little bit did a stupid parking there, but it ended up okay, as did the, all the, you know, drivings of today. No, I haven't seen the traffic, even I was on the Jämsä area. And those all kind of systems went again perfectly. And the final place, that was really nice. Something new, something a little bit surprising, and I have never ever seen that kind of water splashes. So semi-okay day. And I just thought that I have been in this rally on two crash places, but I have seen zero crash. But that is, when you go to the stages like I do, that is how it works. Many times those are the later runners who will crash, but when those are coming, I'm already driving to the next stage. So I'm not sad about it.
Tänne tulee iso liuta vastauksia. Mutta Nussimo!
Yes. Hyvää iltaa, Suomi!
Nussimo on legend.
Josta on,
he's both a people and a special stage of Rally Finland.
Siis minulta kysynä kysyt.
No joo. $572.5. There is the Moxie extra now. I don't know how many, but okay, still.
Oliko se nyt sille, siis sinä olet Jämsän koskelta niinkö?
No siis alkuperä.
Lasagne time again. And planning. I need to transform a lot of files from GoPro to computer, because this is full. So I cannot film anymore, but I do the planning as always. And then I go to sleep.
644.
Eikö on mahtava
Paketar Pensasonsa Regela. Kepeitä rallin loppuja ja mainiota meininkiä kaikille.
Unbelievable. I mean, it just started. And now it was final Pensasonsa. And tomorrow, obviously after 2 hours when I'm waking up, it's the final morning and final day, it's not even full day. This goes so fast these weekends. It's crazy, it should be 4 full days or at least 3.5. Should be longer the rally, but the plans are approximately ready. At the moment I'm fighting a lot still with the disk space, don't know really what to do. I don't know if I can do the whole video, but let's check. If you are hearing this speak on the video, then the video has been made. And I will start from Moxi, of course. Or not of course, but I am starting from the Moxi. On Lehmänpaska corner. And the stage start at 7:53. I will be leaving from home at 5 o'clock. I will be parking at 6:30 in case it really takes that long. Who knows? And then I will be on the spot 7 a.m. It's pretty long walk. Maybe even a bit longer than 30 minutes. I don't know. Depends a lot where I can put the car. I've never ever used the parking that I'm going to use now. But shouldn't be so hurry in the morning tomorrow. And this is the way how I'm going. I had 2 options to go here from the north side. From Petäjävesi. Here. Or then here from the south, from Painaa, use the Hirvimäen tie. And I chose that one because this was a little bit shorter and maybe a bit more simpler at the north side of the stage because the stage is it actually open for me somewhere. So here it is. So this is the road where I want to park, and then there is north side of it. Is still the stage, so I thought it's maybe simpler to go from the south. But there is one question mark, and it is that there is the roadside parking before, and if it gets really full, that there will be a long, a big amount of car. If they are so far away here to the southwest, that could they be blocking the entry to this parking road that I want to use? Or will they block it when I'm coming back? That is a little bit risky, but I will take the risk because personally for me this is more upon that state than the Himos. Let's check a little bit the walk. What it will be, so here is the parking road of mine. And let's check, I can leave my car for example here. 1/2 kilometer from the stage. Then I'll be walking. Oh, it stopped, but we can do that. To the Lehmänpaska corner, which is here. So it will be a little bit more than 2 kilometers. So not extremely long, I guess. And I can show it already on this map. I'm then changing for the second loop to somewhere here. I don't know exactly where are the corners on the map, but somewhere here. Let's say it's there, the place. So the road back to the car will be then something like a bit less than that 2 kilometer. So that is my plan for Himos. Sorry for Moxi. I'm really tired. And you can imagine fighting with the disc base with this tiredness. It's not really easy. I will leave from the first place 9:30. Then I will be on the second place 10, and then the second round of the Moxi starting 10:30, so nothing special for that. But then I try to change till to Himos, and it's starting at 13:15. I will be leaving from the spot of a second run of Moxi 11. I will be my parking 11:20, and now it was approximately 2 kilometers walk, so I think I need to be running a little bit.
And of course, if I just can make it faster, it's all helping me, then where I goes to Himos. And then I will be parking approximately 12:25. I calculate like 20 minutes traffic extra, because there can be a little bit traffic. But I made a good plan that I'm not making hitting the traffic at all. I can show it to you, so let's put this off. And I start here. This is the parking road. I drive here, and then I drive this big road between Petäjävesi and Jämsänkosken tie. And I'm not even going here to the Jämsä area, not even close. North of the Jämsänkoski, I go here on the smaller roads, and I will be parking here. Here are the big parks of Himos, and I think those will be full. Then I'm expecting that people are starting to park here, another side of this big main road. But when I'm going to this area from here, I can like see the end of the traffic, but I'm not in the middle of the traffic. So on the point when I see the end of the traffic, I just park my car and start running. And I hope that I have enough of time. And I still have a plan B. If I don't have enough of time to go to the spectator spot of Himos, plan is to go to the ending hill, downhill, then I just run to the podium. And then I will be watching the podium ceremonials, because there are no podium ceremonials on the city center anymore. Those are the only ones, so it's not a bad plan B. But let's check then. And I have no idea what kind of spectator areas there on the hill, so I will see then. And I will be anyway pretty late there, so I'm not expecting to get a really good place. It's more like enjoying the feeling, atmosphere, and in case I want to watch all car there, I think I will get a better spot then when most of the people are leaving after the rally van and top drivers. So that is the final plan of this weekend, and it's already more than 2 o'clock. I haven't done anything else than just fighting with the disc place. And I just really hope there's so much material. There's like 6 hours on the GoPro already, and one day still to film, that those will be okay. Okay, let's check the results a little bit. Nowadays, when I started to do these videos, most of the places I go, there is someone to talk with, and then listening the rally radio is not so high focused all the time. So it's sometimes I don't really know the results. But Evans is leading. He won 7 out of the 8 stages. Katsusa won the final one, but all the other 7 stages Evans won. Neville in position 2. He is 32.1 seconds behind of Evans. And then Katsuta position 3. 1:27 from the lead. I also missed a little bit the rally radio ending. The focus was not 100% because I need to fight with the computer and the disk space. This is so important weekend for me that I wouldn't like to do it never ever again. So next year I need to find the solutions before the rally. But no can do anymore. It was a little bit low ending now for today. And the beginning of the day was pretty low as well. I got so bored being so long on the same place. But luckily that ended up well on the stages, and let's hope that tomorrow is still a good ending. And I need to leave the home 5 a.m. So I will put it 4:30. Maybe it's okay. I skip at the food doing. I want to sleep now and then I do them in the morning. It's a really bad plan, but I try to make it good. 1 hour and 46 minutes. Not too much, but at least this went better than last year when I was sleeping, you know, 3 naps before I were able to drive home, so. Let's hope I still have some strength tomorrow, and see you then. Good night.
Oho. Hard. Really hard. I mean, the mind, it's starting to figure out every different kind of reasons why not to wake up. But I think one more time.
Yep, I started a little bit late again, 20 minutes. I was so tired when I wake up today. I need to like stop the walking on my home to remember that why I'm even awake, that where I'm walking and what I'm going to do. But now the, you know, body and especially the mind feels that everything is okay again, and same time really nice and happy feeling to go again. But a little bit sad, it's the final morning, but pants are still wet. They didn't like dry up during the night, but I have the seat heater on and pretty hot in the car anyway, and I will be sitting here 1 hour, so I think those will be drying up. Those will be drying up then, now when I'm driving. And weather, it looks really nice. No wind, sun shining, not even a cloud on the sky. It's 50 degrees now, so the magic of 70 degree morning is gone. There you can see a massive layer of fog. So I was a little... Now it raised back to 12, but there was 10 degrees only when we were really close to the... Well, it's not the sea level, but the lake level. Close to the Muurame. Thickest fog so far, but nothing crazy. It would need to be actually really thick fog that it would really affect to the, you know, drivers. Don't know if that kind of fog don't even happen in Finland at least this time of the year. Evgeny Novikov, where he almost did a backflip with the C4 WRC. This one now. Long time since it has been on the Finn rally road. I think something like 2014 last time. I've been hoping to be in Rally Finland. There's this kind of little direction change in the middle of the crest. Nice little lake there. Another crest. But when I've been hoping this place, or when I understand this place, this left side was totally open area. That would be a good place for people, but now it's already forest. Safari Rally Finland continues. Like in some coastland. Thick fog, wide road, but then really basically narrow road condition. Now it's so thick the fog that it's actually affecting to the visibility a little bit in my opinion. I'm going only 50 km per hour and imagine going 150 per hour, so in case there are these kind of places in the stages, it's affecting a little bit. Crazy the conditions in places. Okay, this is now the, or is it? Let's triple check from the map. If I start to follow this road, yep, it will then go here to the, sorry, the camera was pointing wrong, but main thing was that I see where I'm going.
Okay,
let's test. Why there are no cars coming on this direction? Is there something wrong there on the front? Okay, that was a nice guy. He told that there is a trailer or something put it sideways on the road so people can drive it. But there is another way to the spot. Of course, it can be that there is some blocks as well. There's like 1.5 hours before the stage is starting, so not like too much of extra time for all kind of shit. But yeah, if the NATO road is blocked as well, then I need to change my plans totally. Oh, not totally, but try a totally different park. It's working.
Huomenta.
Huomenta.
Sulla on varmaan passi.
I somehow thought that this road is shorter. And because it's not, it's real negative news when I commit to change to the Himo stage. And it's that kind of high, the middle part of the road, that I need to be safe and drive like other side of the road. So either the left or right tire will go to the high part. Which means also that the speed when we are going back is not going to be extremely high. First car approximately 500 meters before I thought that it will be the parking. Starting to be more cars, but of course really unknown where will be the end of the cars. Drone would be nice.
No, mitä sä haluaisit hänestä
tietää? You could fly and check.
No annapa tulla semmonen
vai kengän koon vai kunnon
litania sieltä. Takamotto
katsotaan. No ei sillä ehkä ole merkitystä, mutta tota, sehän oli tietysti eilisen ehdottomasti jännimpi.
No, well, it was pretty clear that it's here. Approximately just on the spot where I thought it will be, so everything okay, now just quick backpack and let's go. Veto, veto. It's really, really cold. Cold and damp. Huomenta. This is now a thing that I've been so many times doing. Normally walking there from the forest to my favorite place. It's still like really cold. Feels like a winter, but I guess that when at least where I'm going, it should be that the sun is hitting there, and because it's not winter, the sun will be warming really nicely. Feels good to be here. Fresh air and my favorite place, and one more proper rally morning. after a 10 minutes walk, I'm almost halfway to the distance and the body feels good, like really good. This will be a good running day and it's good because it's needed then on the Himos especially. Now enough. I just can't say enough how cool it is now to be here. Perfect morning stage weather, absolutely perfect. Latvali starting second on the road here, likes this stage a lot. And I, in case it's just not too sleepy because of the coldness or something like that, I guess he will be enjoying crazy much. This is the Rekka line. They have driven even so deep with the Rekka cars to check if there are any stones, if they can cut. It's so rare that I've been actually here on the first bus. It has always been the second bus through. And so often the last stage of the day, so it's basically a new perspective now for me to this corner, and it's really welcome. I've been telling a lot of good things about this corner on the stage analysis videos. Let's check if there is now a lot of people. Someone said to me that I will ruin my secret spots, but I don't think so. There.
Oh, it's okay. Come on.
No.
tonne noin. Sitten noin kaksi viimeistä kaveria, niin mennään sitten. Kärkiä mennään
No entäs tää nyt on kivellä pinää kyllä?
Ei tietenkään.
Niin.
Niin se voi tietysti pyörittää yli.
Joo, se on ihan. Nähdään taas jossain.
No, veto vaan.
Kiitos, kiitos, moro. Issue, because my power bank went from 70% to 0 in 1 second, so I don't have a power bank anymore. So I try to film quite a little, but that, you know, the first place, everything was perfect. The weather, atmosphere, even the direction of the wind, because it was from the stage start. So even if that was approximately halfway point of the stage, it was possible to hear the car all the way from the stage start to the place where I was, and almost the same situation on the second place. That wasn't so spectacular than I thought, because you know, it's Sunday and people are driving slowly, just saving their car for the power stage. But okay place as well, and now let's check this Himos, how much I need to run. I forgot my proteins to the car. It will be a catabolic day, but no can do anymore. So far okay, no traffic, of course, slow cars now, that one, front of us. Okay, start to feel pretty tired, so I have 2 Red Bulls left, so I decided I do 1 now, and I hope this will help me to stay awake on the power stage, and then I will have 1, because I need to drive to the home as well. And then when I home, it doesn't matter anything, I can sleep like 20 hours, and that will happen. So that is the Red Bull plan of the final stage, and sad feeling is this is the final road section for me. Then it's 1 long year. But really nice day so far.
Teemu Suniseen, Mikko Markkula vielä täällä tällä
hetkellä. No one is following.
Ollaan siellä Suninen.
Kyllä, napanuora on katkaistu.
This may be my...
Ja nyt Teemu Suninen täällä.
my best plan of the rally.
Pistää ajopukua kuntoon. Pikkusen kansa kohahteli, kun pudotit tohon.
Let's check. I guess this is good.
No. Pitääkö tässä tehdä huoltotoimenpiteet itse vai saako tiimipäki tehdä autoon muutokset?
Sieltä tulee pieni apu. Oliko mekanikko vai kaksi? Ja
again, I'm somewhere where I've never been before.
Kiitos sulle ja tsemppi loppupäivä.
Kiitos.
From backyard of Jämsänkoski. It's really true that there is no one here. First car. Okay, I take no more risk. I park here and let's go. This is good enough. Final important road section for me. Job done. Everything perfect. Expect the mistake of Google Maps. That cost me 10 seconds. Minutes. Okay, so there is the goal. Let's check. I have no idea still of the spectator areas or nothing what there is possible to do. I need to put some messages. But I should have good time. I've write some messages and then start the running. 11:58 is the time. I would like to go there on the top, but I just can't see that there are people. So is it all of it place to be or not? Don't know. It's just like on music festivals where I have been here few times. Almost at the top. Bit worrying as I see no one here. It would be a bit sad if this would be forbidden. I check the view from there and then I walk back to the down if it's shit from there. This is pointless. Back to the down. I don't know about that spot that I like a lot in the forest. There are a few people, if those are normal spectator or some photographer systems people. No keskiviikko torstai yönä en yhtään. Sitten torstaina 2 tunnin päikkärit. Sitten taisi tulla 3 tuntia torstai perjantai yönä. Sitten perjantai lauantai 2 ja nyt lauantai sunnuntai 2.
2.
Joo. Tai 1:45.
Moro.
Joo, no niin, morjesta.
Tervente Rally Radio. Sad moment when it ends and specially now they play the last song was Hello Darkness My Old Friend. So it's now like 1 year of darkness again. That is a really good reason why my car is there on the after a bit more than 1 kilometer of walk, but I will be so much more earlier home than these guys here. Didn't get really good. I left before Evans from the spectator area and run to the podium, but didn't get a really good place. But there were the Rally 2 cars when Pajari came, and of course the Rally 3 podium, then the spot was good. It was nice way. It has been somehow my tradition to always run to the podium, normally from Ruuhimäki and then drive a little bit, so even if it was now on the different place, it still ended like it has used to end in almost every year. And greetings to everyone who came and say hello. It's nice to see that those are helpful, the stage analysis videos and recce videos. That's, you know, people can find that kind of spectating spot that they like. That's a little bit like the whole point of those videos, so it's nice to see that those are working. And for sure, special thanks to mom to making the lasagne. I don't know how many kilos I ate that, but that was of course really important to have that when I came home. It's actually pretty much perfect food after a rally day, because first of all lots of energy and then good high quality protein. That is something that many times is missing during the rally days. Those were the kilometers. 689.4. It's hot, 24 degrees. Tomorrow will be close to 30 and it smells like boiling Red Bull in the car, Vemsenkoski. But okay, I can say now that we are on the big road, or basically still in the Jämsenkoski, but anyway. Time to sum up the rally. I don't know how to do it because the brains are pretty dead, but
Well, body is okay. That's last year the body was not so okay. So I think one critical thing was that last year I slept 0 hour between Friday and Saturday. This year I slept 1 hour and 45 minutes. So it's definitely a better to sleep a little bit even than not at all. That's what we learn. And of course I learned that my thing is definitely to run with the Rally 1 cars, not do like I did on Saturday. That was like basically the only negative thing of this year's rally, in my opinion, in my rally, my spectating experience. I was in a little bit bad feeling there on yesterday, but this morning again the feeling changed. It was just perfect rally morning, beautiful place. And it wasn't so bad the Himos either. Of course, it was pretty stupid that I ran to the top of the hill, and then without any good reason, in my opinion, there was not a spectator spot. They just say that no, because of no. Like, it was a crest, and I would have been there on the left side of the crest, above the road level, like 10 meters away from the road. And if the car goes like 150 km over the crest, it doesn't suddenly take a 90 degree curve and can turn and go and kill me. So I didn't really see the reason of that. But on the other hand, then I had time to go to the podium. So that was okay. And the Friday as well, really good, close to the perfect. And no traffic. I don't know if I have been even 1 minute on the traffic, basically. And it doesn't count. Maybe there on the Halttula when I was turning around finding the parking spot, but other way it was good. And I was really lucky with the weather. I didn't spend so much time on the rain like many people did, like many hours. So everything was basically okay now. Oh, thanks for watching and see you next year.